This video shows how to use the Windows 8 family safety features to protect your family when using the computer. If you are sharing your computer with your children, there are steps you can take to increase their safety online, such as setting up a child account, monitoring their activity, and restricting certain apps and websites. To set up a child account, you will need to log in with an administrator account. When you've logged in, type account from the start screen and then select Add, Delete, and Manage Other User Accounts. Click Add an Account and then click Add a Child's Account. If your child has an existing email account, you can enter it here. If not, you can create a new Microsoft email account. If your child does not need to attach an email to their account, select Add a Child's Account without email. In this example, we will use a Microsoft account. Click Next to continue. Click Finish and have your child sign in to activate their account. To manage your child's account locally, type Family Safety from the start screen and select Family Safety from the results list. Select the child account you want to manage. Activity reporting is turned on by default for child accounts and can be viewed by clicking View Activity Reports. If you want to set limits for your child's account, you can set restrictions such as web filtering, time limits, games, and apps. Alternatively, if you are using a Microsoft Live account, you can manage your child's account permissions online at familysafety.live.com. Sign in with your Microsoft Live account. The accounts and devices that are connected to the Family Safety Group are listed here. If your child has more than one account, you can combine them by clicking Link Family Members at the top of the page. Select the accounts you want to link and click OK. Select the primary child account and then click Combine Accounts. To add another parent account, click Add a Parent. Enter the email address of the account to send an email request and click Send Request. The status of the request will be displayed on your Family Safety homepage. Select a connected child account to adjust settings for that account. An overview page displays showing you a summary of the account's recent activities. Use the navigation menu on the left to review and adjust settings for this account. Activity reporting shows the actions taken with this account, including web activity and PC activity, which can be filtered by date. Activity reports will also be sent weekly to your email address, along with the status updates and other information. Web filtering allows you to restrict websites based on preset levels or to block specific websites. Turn on web filtering and then select a filter level. To set specific filters, click Allow or Block List, ensure the filter list is turned on, and then fill in the website address you want to manage. Click Allow or Block to add the website to each list. If you change your mind about a website, click the trash can icon to remove it. To set time restrictions on computer use, click Time Limits and then turn on Time Allowance. You can choose to set limits by weekday and weekend or by individual day. Click Curfew to set limits based on the time of day. Click the On switch to activate curfew and select the times you want to block by clicking and dragging the Days and Hours table. Another option is to block games and Windows Store apps. To block games, click Game Restrictions. Turn on the Ratings feature and then select a rating level or choose specific games to block or allow. When your child logs into the account, a message will appear saying the account is monitored by Family Safety. If your child attempts to access a restricted app, a message will appear letting them know the app has been blocked and to click the message to request access, which gives the option to provide a parent's password for permission right then, or to send a request. If your child has requested access to a website or app that has been blocked, or asks for more computer time, you can review requests online and then choose to allow or ignore. You will also receive email notifications for any requests as well. You can find additional helpful videos at hp.com/supportvideos and on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/how-to for you.